That is a whole... Shut up. That is a whole bunch of Octominer 12Xs. Let's get these inside. Well, there we are. We have six of these 12Xs. I'm actually noticing that one has the PSU in the back, which is a little interesting. And it appears one is missing a motherboard entirely. But, yeah. That must have been an option to have a PSU in the front or the back. Fascinating. Some of the fans have been moved out to the front, I'm guessing just for beefier GPUs, but I'm going to pull the lids on all of these and see how many of them are missing things, how many of them are damaged. Then I'm going to test boot each and every one of them as well, just to see if they're still working. Alright, I've got the first one hooked up to Ethernet, I got my temp boot drive, we'll hook it into power in just a second here, but I'm noticing... We actually have evidence of some branding on this one, Octominer X12 Pro. Interesting, interesting. And this is saying 2018-31, so the backplane on the other one was actually newer, but it didn't have the sticker on it. So these are indeed 2017 or 2018, potentially. Fascinating. The front panel header connectors were just buried over here. There was a bunch of PCIe just kind of chilling over there, so I'm not really sure what's going on, but let's hook it up and see if this one works. It does say bad PSU on the lid, but I don't know if I believe any of this crap. All right, so no activity so far. I did swap the RAM from one channel to another. I'm not sure if the RAM's even good. Not sure what exactly is going on. Could indeed be, you know, low voltage on the PSU. The fans do work just fine, so I'm inclined to believe that the PSU is okay. I may elect to rip this thing out later, but let's first see if we get any of these to post. And if we do, then I'm going to try swapping the RAM over to see if the RAM is bad, and just sort of do a little bit of troubleshooting that way. But I will say, I think there's an issue with the board, because when I turn on the power supply, this does not automatically power on. So I'm actually going to go ahead and pull the coin cell right now too. Make sure that the BIOS fully resets. And I did find the mSATA just kind of clanking around inside this thing. I'm sure that's good for it. But let's move on to the much cleaner looking case number two. Let's see what we can get out of this bad boy. All right. Back to the BTC V1.02. This one is made in 2020, so I'm guessing that is indeed a replacement board. I'm gonna go ahead and pull the MSAT out of this because I do not want to boot into his old hive farm. I want to boot into mine. So let's rip that out and let's fire this up. Well, we've got flashing Ethernet lights and they just turned out, which means if they come back on, it's pretty likely that we're booting into Hive. A great first sign, and if so, we're gonna immediately try swapping the RAM from this case into that one. And I did see on the front of this one, not posting to BIOS, which, yep, that seems pretty accurate to me. Well, let's see, are our Ethernet lights back on? They are. Let's check Hive. Okay, so there we see it. Everything comes up okay. All I had to do was change the actual rig config. It was pulling up the wrong rig, so. Anyway, this one seems fine, which is great. Let me move the RAM over and let's see. In fact, I don't even, oh, wow. Really? It's 1 gig of RAM? No way. Okay, so the RAM is okay. I did swap it over. We'll try the other Octo after this, but I may end up pulling that motherboard out entirely. We can check on it, but we'll run through the other Octos first. I just want to see if that was actually correct. It is DDR3, so it is possible it's a 1 gig DIMM if they just ran out of other crap, but boy, you wouldn't be able to run much for mining on a 1 gigabyte configuration. Well, we can see that it worked for sure because we're at 3.2 gigs free, which means we use just under a gig, which means that that's a 2 gig DIMM. Still not nearly enough, so we'll probably have to buy some more RAM for these anyway, but that second Octo is good and we've confirmed that that RAM is good. So let me shut this back down and let's test the next one. And this one appears good too. The fan grills were pushing pretty hard on a couple of these. And that one is just absolutely decimated, but it booted up just fine. Let's see, it looks like it has 4 gigs of RAM. I should be paying attention to the CPUs here too. i3-6100, 4 gigs of RAM. That one looks fine too. All right, I'll shut her down. Let's see what our next one holds. And this one looks like it's had a replaced mainboard as well because it has no front panel headers connected. Other than that though, I mean, it did boot just fine. This is the one with the reverse power supply. Let's see what we have for a CPU. 6100, 4 gigs of RAM. So, okay, well, at least it's working. That's good. Let's open up the next one. Well, this one's the best so far, 8 gigs of RAM. However, it's missing an mSATA. I got shafted. But no, this one, A-OK. We had a little bit of damage on one of the end fan grills, but seems fine. So, other than missing an mSATA and missing a little backplate there, seems okay. Oh, interesting. I actually just noticed that's got a later BIOS on it, 2021. So, that was definitely replaced. Well, we got us another no post. So, the first and the last, no bueno. Pull the boards out. And the rest of them are okay, actually. So that's pretty nice. Not bad for a batch of six that look like they got shipped over, thrown over the side of the MMPoS or something. Well, I've extracted the motherboard. I'm going to go ahead and reseat the CPU. Actually, I'm going to swap the CPU entirely. And, let's just see. Not going to hurt anything by trying. All right, well, I got number six to work. That's pretty cool. Turns out the soft power on functionality is not working on this motherboard. So I'm actually going to try to flash it with the more recent Octominer BIOS. I don't know. Let's see. I bet it won't work. Oh my god, the flash is actually working on this thing. No way. Cool. So I'm flashing an Octominer X12 BIOS onto this board. Let's see if I brick it. Amusingly, I was able to flash an Octominer X12 BIOS onto it, so you know the boards are very similar, but yeah, I'm not sure if that really gains me anything. It's just funny when you boot it, you get that splash screen. Oh, I guess we don't get the splash screen. I did the first time, but it says Octominer X12 Ultra there. All right, I got them all to flash. Well, all the ones that would boot, not that one. Yeah, I'm just gonna label them. Say that they were BIOS flashed, I'll say what CPU they have, how much RAM they have. One of these, I think, only has 2 gigs of RAM, but I think it's the one with the bad motherboard, so no biggie. Yep, just going to seal them back up and save them for a rainy day at this point. I don't really need more 12 GPU CPU cases right now. Or, sorry, 12 GPU cases right now. But I know I will, and the getting was so good on these, I just could not say no. So, the BIOS flash should give me the ability to run 12 AMD RDNA2 cards in each one of these, which would be swell. I know that was an issue even with the early X12 Ultra Pluses there, so yeah. That's really cool that we could flash it down there. We get that nice Octominer splash screen on the BIOS. And yeah, everything is good other than that final one. Hopefully he can send me a new motherboard. Other than that, I might bite the bullet and just buy an X12 Ultra Plus motherboard because I'm pretty sure it'll work. Yeah, I think that's it for this one, but let me know what you guys think of these ancient Octominer X12 Pros, I guess they're called. Fascinating little cases.